See if I can get a word with Chris. Chris, how'd your car run tonight?
Yeah, I think car's pretty good, but like Rudy, he's been real fast, and Dawg's been knocking on the door, so hopefully we'll rebound from last week and be able to come out here for winning tonight.
Does the strategy change much doing a 30-lap run, a 50-lap run?
Well, not a whole lot. Every week you come out here to win, and that's what we're here for.
All right, good luck tonight. Y'all, any newcomers here? Been around for a while. Chris Johnson, son of Eddie Johnson, used to be a big Ford driver, had a lot of Ford fans that always rooted Eddie on. Eddie probably be here next week for the 200-lapper. Defending champion Sean Beluso here. Sean Layback, got to wake him up. Sean's one of the old guys in the series here. John, what's the strategy?
Win the race. We need to get a win this year.
It's been a dry year, but you've had good runs.
We keep getting our butts kicked by these young guys.
Well, what does that tell you?
That I need to go faster?
Yeah, but just drink a Mountain Dew or something before the race.
Hey, I got some Red Bull. Even though they're getting out of NASCAR, I still drank some Red Bull before the race starts.
Now, will you push the issue early since it's only a 30-lapper?
Yeah, you got to go to the front. 30 laps, you just got to go as quick as you can. Mike is on a rail. I mean, even more than Cameron was. He's going to be tough to beat. There's about five of us. They're all the same. But Mike's far and above us.
All right, Sean Beluso. Speaking of Mike, he's the pole winner, last winner out here at the racetrack. Let me see if I can get a word with him here. Mike, got it hooked up.
Yeah, ran pretty good. We're a little bit off in practice. I guess we had some old tires, but put the new tires on. She's running good. I'd like to thank everyone, my crew, the Marines, my sponsor, Happy, and everybody's helped me out, my wife, and hopefully we can get another win here tonight and make it 3 in a row.
I know you've been getting closer and closer each week. Look like you finally found a balance the last few weeks. Any one thing that you can point out that made a difference?
Well, it's a whole bunch of things. We come to the track every week with a different setup, and just because we win one week, we're still trying to get faster, so hopefully we made the right decision, everything on the car.
All right, good luck tonight. Your pole winner there. We'll make way on back here a little more. This young man here is only like his fifth race on asphalt. He comes from dirt, running sprint cars and everything. Randy Monroe. Randy, looks like you're getting a little more used to asphalt each week.
What's that?
I said, looks like you're getting a little more used to the asphalt.
Yeah, I am. You know, this is a new team. We're here this year, and me and my crew chief Bobby have both had a couple years off, and you know, with the new car and everything, we're both getting used to everything again, but we're definitely finding it each week. We're getting better and better, and I think here within the next couple of weeks, we'll have something for these guys up front every week.
What seemed to be the biggest challenge switching from dirt to asphalt?
Probably patience. And since I've driven sprint cars for the past few years, the weight, going from an 800-pound car to, you know, these big body cars is probably the biggest challenge. Sorry.
Right, good luck tonight. Keep an eye on the 03. He'll be moving up through the pack here. Let me get one more word here as they're still lining up the cars. Cameron Patrick, I don't know, Mike, you would know if he's still the points leader. He had some rough luck last week, not only blew one motor, but blew two motors. And I understand he might be having a little motor problem today. Cameron, how's the motor in there?
The motor's actually too strong compared to the last one we had in here. It's kind of hurting my times right now, but if it stays together, we should have a little run to go after them guys in front of us.
Looks like you've had the car to beat handling-wise, and like I said, I was telling the fans you had a little bad luck with your motor program and stuff last week, and but you think you got everything turned around and you make a good run this tonight?
Well, we've been hurting a little bit on the fact of having motor issues. We haven't had as much time to practice and get the car set up, but we think we got it pretty close, and we got enough motor to stay with them, and usually if I keep it close to them, I'll have a shot at it.
All right, Cameron Patrick in the number 20.
And by the way, Wayne, Sean Beluso, with his consistency this year, is the points leader. Cameron Patrick second. They're separated by only 6 points.
And to give us the command tonight is General Will Frazier. And figured since you're the commander of Air Combat Command, it'd be appropriate to let you start these guys up. So if you would, sir, give us the most famous words in racing.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Here we go. It's rock and roll time. Thank you very much, General. Great having you out here.
Sean Beluso, who leads the points with consistent runs, third in tonight's event as far as qualifying goes. And Chris Johnson, 36 on the outside front row. Mike Rudy, the two wins that he has, got him in a good spot to win a championship this year. If he can get back up there and win a few more, the 8 car will begin the race out front. KeysVacation.com Modified's giving you two 30-lap events tonight at Langley, the Friday night edition of our Saturday night show on the 4th of July weekend. Cycle City Corp Legends will run next for 25 laps, the Enduros for 50, the Pepsi Grand Stocks for 40, then we'll have the fireworks from the Zambelli Brothers. KeysVacation.com Modified, second to win. Here's the first. As Jimmy Walker, our flagman, will let the green flag blow in the breeze. We are underway. Mike Grudy makes his way between turns one and two, gets a good bite out of turn two, stays ahead about two car lengths. Sean Beluzzo back in second. Then a side-by-side battle down low. Cameron Patrick in the yellow and the black, number 20. Chris Johnson on the outside in car 36. They make a little contact between turns one and two. Door-to-door battle in the back straightaway now between three and four. Mike Rudy leads Sean Beluzzo, then Chris Johnson, Cameron Patrick, Jimmy Humblett, Joe Bruce, Joe Scarborough up there in the top 10. He is six. Hunter Slayton, Robbie Babb, and Randy Monroe Jr. in the top 10. Joe Bruce now battles Robbie Babb as he pulls ahead. Randy Monroe Jr. now. He slips a little bit at the exit of turn four. Car got kicked sideways. He falls back in line behind Joe Bruce in 77. Anthony Kincaid coming to the front, gets inside 33, Matt Slide. He will make the pass. Smoke coming out of the back end of the 7 car. Matt Carter, officials are watching that as smoke continues to come out of the back end of the 7. 4 laps completed, now 5. Sean Beluzzo leads the points. No wins this year, but lots of consistent runs. Then Cameron Patrick with 4 wins. Chris Johnson third in points. Hunter Slayton fourth, running for the Rookie of the Year. As the 57 comes down pit road, Todd Van Gilder. Mike Rudy in the top 5 in points. But if he can get a few more wins, he'll be right up there in the hunt with the leaders. Sean Beluzzo and Cameron Patrick. Beluzzo looks like he's closing in a little bit on Mike Rudy. Meanwhile, this battle rages on back here as Robbie Babb comes to the front, gets by Jimmy Humblett in the 11. Robbie Babb up in fifth. First and second separated by about 2.5 car lengths. The 1 and the 0-3, Anthony Kincaid and Randy Monroe Jr. with a good battle now as Anthony takes that position away in the 1 car. 8 laps completed. Jimmy Humblett for the 11A. I think that is the 11A, Jimmy Humblett Jr. He is Chris Humblett in the 11A, and he's on pit road. Robbie Babb, he's got a fast car tonight. He goes to the inside of Cameron Patrick. So Babb is hooked up. He takes over the fourth position. 20 laps to go for Mike Rudy. Sean Beluzzo able to stay right with him. Meanwhile, Anthony Kincaid has a fast car too tonight. He gets to the inside of the 08. Joe Scarborough makes the pass between turns one and two. Joe fights him a little bit on the outside. But Anthony does take that position away. Sean Beluzzo closing up to the back end of the 8 of Mike Rudy as we're on lap 12. Anthony Kincaid trying to get to the inside of Jimmy Humblett a little bit further back, just outside the top 5. Beluzzo looks on the outside of Mike Rudy. Sean Beluzzo leads the points, would like to get a victory this year. Last year's champion closing in on the leader, Mike Rudy. Mike of Prince George, Virginia, Advance Auto Parts, United States Marines, A1 Tire, Connolly Tattoo sponsoring his ride, and the 48 of Sean Beluzzo, like we said, last year's champion from Hampton, Virginia. Easy Auto of Newport News, Gene Nichols, Standard Welding, signs and graphics to go, and Skip's Body Shop. And the 36, Chris Johnson, looking for sponsorship on his ride, son of Eddie Johnson, and a very good driver, too. Battle rages on between Beluzzo and Rudy up front. the 8 and the 48. Robbie Babb, the 44, still closing in on the 36. Went to the inside of a lap car at the exit of turn number 2. The black flag is going out for the 7 for that smoke we mentioned earlier. 7 machine of Matt Carter left coming to the pits. Beluso looking to make a pass on Mike Rudy for the lead. Dives on the inside at the exit of turn 4. Couldn't quite get it done. Back end kicked out a little bit. He went a little bit too low down in turn 4. Now at the exit of turn 2, loses a little bit of ground to Mike Rudy. About 2.5 car lengths now back. As they continue to race, Chris Johnson seems like he's closing in on these two guys. Robbie Babb still coming. He's back and forth in car 44. And Cameron Patrick, the 20 car, is in fifth. Sixth position, Anthony Kincaid. The 08, Joe Scarborough is 7th, Randy Monroe Jr., 03 is 8th, and Jimmy Humblett, Joe Bruce, 71 is in the pits, Hunter Slayton, and also the 7, Matt Carter trying to figure out what is smoking on the machine. 10 laps to go in the first 30 lap modified race. Coming up on Matt Slies, number 33, and Mike Rudy dives on the inside, makes the pass. Now Beluso will also make the pass. Beluso with his tongue hanging out, trying to catch Mike Rudy's 8. Chris Johnson back here in the third spot in car 36. And he's about 8 car lengths ahead of Robbie Babb. Robbie seems like he's hooked up tonight. Robbie is 10th in the points. Robbie started the race in 12th and has moved all the way up into the 4th position. And as we get down to the end of this race, it looks like lap traffic might come into play just a bit because we have a lot of guys racing with each other. The 11 and the 87. And that is James, Jimmy Humblett, Darrell Vance racing for the 10th spot. Anthony Kincaid trying to get by Cameron Patrick's number 20. That is for the 5th position. Kincaid all over the back rear end bar of the 20 of Cameron Patrick. Cameron with 4 wins this year. He's got pressure from Anthony Kincaid again. Came down low on the racetrack that time. Anthony couldn't quite make the pass. Robbie Babb is still closing in on Chris Johnson for that 3rd position. And Beluso still about 2.5 car lengths behind Mike Rudy, 1st and 2nd. 3 laps to go. Mike Rudy leads Shaw Beluso, Chris Johnson, Robbie Babb, Cameron Patrick, the top 5, then Anthony Kincaid, Joe Scarborough, Randy Monroe Jr., Joe Bruce, Darrell Vance, the top 10, then Jimmy Humblett, Matt Sly, Brandon Harding, Hunter Slayton, Matt Carter, Todd Van Gilder, the way they run. Now the checkered flag is going to come out the next time by Mike Rudy. Mike Rudy sees the checkered flag. It is win number 3 for 2011 for Mike Rudy. Shaw Beluso will finish 2nd. He'll have a good points day for the first race of the nighttime. The first twin, 30. Chris Johnson, he is the 36 car in 3rd. Robbie Babb, the 44 in 4th. Cameron Patrick all in the top 5. So Mike Rudy wins race number 3 for 2011. And Shaw Beluso came into tonight's race leading the points and had a good run, but couldn't quite catch that 8 machine of Mike Rudy. And Rudy will get the checkered flag again for win number 3 for 2011. Cameron Patrick also having a very good year, 2nd in the points, and he had a top 5 finish. He was 5th behind Robbie Babb, Chris Johnson, Shaw Beluso, Mike Rudy, who wins. And I know Robbie Babb was hoping for a caution flag, even though we didn't have any, because he had one of the fastest cars on the racetrack, consistently with lap times and speed. And Robbie Babb came from 12th all the way to 4th. Anthony Kincaid finishes 6th. Joe Scarborough, the 7th position. Randy Monroe Jr. in the 8th. Joe Bruce, 77, was 9th. And Darrell Vance, the 87, in the top 10. Let's go down track side, and here is Chuck Hall.
Man, I tell you what, this team has really turned it around in 2011. Another win. The 8 car puts it back in victory lane here tonight, and another race to come. Immediately following the fireworks tonight, can he make it a foursome? We will find out for the 8 car as he gets congratulations from crew members. And, man, what a – this car is on a rail. Can you tell us the secret?
Just hard work. That's all it is. You work on your car constantly, you're going to pay off in the long run.
Well, you got to have a great driver, too, and this young man certainly is a good driver. He'll get unstrapped, and we'll talk to the winner of the 8 car, ladies and gentlemen. More straps to get unstrapped there. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Mike Rudy right there, number 8. Mike, come on out front here. Another hot summer night, and boy, you got a hot car there. This thing... Can you tell us the secret? All the competitors are over there wanting to know what the secret is.
I'll be honest with you, there on that about 18 to go, I'm running on 7 cylinders because the car was missing pretty bad. I don't know if I got a spark plug, wire burn up, or something in the carburetor, but it was missing. Maybe that might have helped a little bit of traction a little bit, but Luzo would make a gain on me, but then I would get him a little bit in the corners. But I was down on motor, and hopefully the motor will be all right for the second race.
And we do have a twin race coming up, another race for the KeysVacation.com Modifieds here. And I know you got a lot of sponsors that help you out. Old Point National Bank on board, and they're going to be presenting you with the trophy. But let's talk about yours for a moment.
Well, I'd like to thank Advanced Auto Parts, United States Marines. They help us out with fuel. Keys Vacation, Old Point National Bank for sponsoring tonight's race. I'd like to thank God, my crew, my cousin Chris here. He spends a lot of time on the race car, my wife, and everybody helps out.
Well, let's go meet Lori and Sandy here from Old Point National Bank. They've got a winning trophy for you, a great bank, a great driver. What a great night of racing. Go ahead and meet the driver, Mike Rudy right there. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up. They're the 8 driver in Modifieds, most recent winner, Mike Rudy right there.
Mike, you got DQ'd for something that was just not right. I know that's not how you wanted to win, but you were in position to take advantage of it. And what changes have you made to your car to put this thing up front for the whole race this time?
Well, hopefully, yeah, and we hate to win it that way, but stuff happens. You just got to be in a position when something happens like that. But anyways, we tightened the car up a little bit. We tore up the right rear tire pretty bad, and we made some adjustments. Hopefully the car will be better and we'll be able to move to the front. It's been a long year. It's been the hardest year we've ever had. I really appreciate all the fan support out there. I hear from people all the time, and we really appreciate all the people who come out to Langley Speedway every week and support all the cars out here, all the modifieds, and keep on coming out here. We're going to try and run to Hampton Heat next week with the late model also.
All right. Well, I did look at the right rear tire. It does have a groove all the way around. You think it's going to hold up?
Yeah, we hope so. It is blistered like we've never blistered the tire before, but a few of the cars blistered tires, but some of the ones that are right behind me have really good right rear tires, and that's going to make the difference tonight.
All right. Sean Beluso, driver number 48, modified down here. He was your winner for the last race. The 8 car, Mike, had a little bit of carburetor problem. I know they've got another carburetor on there. He said it's the same carburetor, been running for the last couple races. And it passed. Just one of them deal, one of them parts failures or something went wrong. I've been knowing Mike for a long time, and I know he wouldn't deliberately do anything like that. He's got too much to lose. Let me see if I can get a word with him while he's strapping in. Mike, I was telling the fans that, knowing you for a long time, I know you didn't do that on purpose. Just one of them parts failures or whatever it was that end up costing you a win. Now you got to come all the way from the back. Any different strategy?
No, it was just the base plate was a little big on it. Checked it 4 weeks ago and it passed, so not going to worry about that. You know, it hurts my pride a little bit because I don't like being DQ'd, never have been. And so
y'all just watch some fireworks. You can get ready to see some more coming from the rear. So
there you go. Driver number 8 car. He said he is coming up through there, and he ain't making any friends while he's doing it. Mike, I'm going to throw it up to you while the smoke clears out. What a heck of a fireworks show, folks. I'll tell you what, man. Woo! Let me bring you up to speed. What's going on? Car. The 48 car has a blistered right rear tire. I looked at it after the first race. They reversed it on the rim, and we'll see how it holds up. 36 cars got a good car underneath them. Watch Chris. He's got a good chance of winning. Robbie Babb has been steady moving up each week. 44 car, he is doing real well. We'll see how he does for this race. He's a good chance to win. 20 car, they moved some lead on it. The car is not handling well since they changed the motor. So they moved some lead around, trying to get it to handle better. One car having oil pressure problems. They changed the oil, changed the filter, still having problems. I looked at it when he cranked it up. If I had to take a guess, I'd say the oil pickup is coming loose on it. The 7 car has a Ford motor in that car, so you Ford fans can root for the 7, but he was having motor problems also. And as we well know, the 8 car has changed carburetors and has to go to rear. So that brings you up to speed, everything going on for this 30-lap event. Get ready to start.
All right, excellent, Wayne. Let's go back to Chuck, if we can. Chuck, can you still hear me? Chuck Hall.
A good friend of ours, Chris Russo, is in the hospital. He's having a tough time, and just remember him in your prayers tonight. And, you know, Chris is a big fan of Langley Speedway. Been out here a lot of years, owner of the Anna's Pizza. And we just want to give his family and himself our best wishes, heartfelt wishes, and just remember him in your prayer tonight. Thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you, and we will. We love Chris Russo, an amazing guy. It is Old Point National Bank here at Langley Speedway. We thank all the fine, nice folks from Old Point National Bank for helping us out tonight with the sponsorship as we get set to go for the final race of the nighttime for our 4th of July celebration, the KeysVacation.com Modifieds, underway for the second time. Between turns 1 and 2, bumping and banging already on the first lap of this 30-lap event, here goes Robbie Babb to the inside of Sean Beluso in a big crash and upside down on the back straightaway. Randy Monroe Jr. upside down in turn 3. 77 also involved in this big wreck on the back straightaway is Joe Bruce, and they don't get one lap completed in the 0-3 upside down. Also the one Anthony Kincaid involved. Officials run over and check on Randy Monroe Jr. in the 0-3 to make sure he's okay. Rescue checking the condition of Randy Monroe Jr. Anytime you have a car upside down, you always have to be concerned about fuel or any liquid spilling and igniting on anything that might be hot. So they're making sure that they've got the fire extinguishers out just in case. And they will throw the red flag, of course. Long come to a stop and make sure that Randy is okay. And we will keep things silent here on the speakers until we can find out what's going on with Randy.
Mike, I don't know if you can hear me over there. The driver is out. The driver's okay. They're checking him out, but he is unhurt. The car's got some damage, but it can be fixed. But what a spectacular wreck, I tell you. But the driver is out, and he's doing fine. Back up to you.
Good deal. Thank you, Wayne. That is what we were concerned about.
Randy, first, you're okay?
Yeah, I'm pretty good.
Hey, do you have any idea what happened? I mean, I know things happen so quick, and it's, you know, beginning of the race, and everybody's running bumper to bumper.
Yeah, you know, we were sitting there, like you said, it was the start of the race, running in a tight pack, and we went into one and two, and I think the one just got a little loose, and I don't know, I think he grabbed the brakes, and I just couldn't check up in time, and got into him a little bit, and then somebody hit me from the rear, and we got straightened out going down two, and I think the one was a little loose when he come up off of two, and he might have overcorrected, and when I checked up, somebody drilled me from behind and turned me straight to the wall, and I guess rolled over on my side. I'm okay. I've had worse, but I think the car's pretty tore, but hopefully we can get it back.
Well, I know you used to drive sprint cars, so I doubt this is the first time you've been on your roof.
No, I've been on my roof, I could count three other times, but yeah, the time in the sprint car was pretty bad, but I've never been upside down on the asphalt, so.
Hey, I know you got a charity you're racing for.
Yeah, I'm driving out here for Racing for Hope for Matthew Hare. You know, he has leukemia, and we're out here trying to raise money for him, and anything we can do to support his foundation and raise money for him and all the other kids out there, it's really important to us, and we want to see him get better.
All right, well, I see your car owner underneath there, Bobby. I'll get this thing fixed and have you back out here in a couple weeks.
I sure hope so. Thank you.
All right, Randy Moreau. The driver is okay. Car does have some damage, but that can be fixed. Back up to you, Mike.
All right, Wayne, thank you. Good to know that Randy is all right. Right, they're going to line up side by side, and it will be a complete restart except for those cars involved in the big wreck we had in turn number three as we get set to go for the KeysVacation.com modifieds at Langley Speedway. Once again, thank you for your patience as we had the track cleanup underway. Pace truck is in. Dave Terrell, our pace truck driver, takes it in. Jimmy Walker, our flagman, is going to wave the green flag, and we're back underway. Sean Beluso gets a good fight at the exit of turn number two. Robbie Babb is down there low. Looks like the complete restart that we had the first time. Robbie Babb's got a fast car tonight, that 44 machine on the inside of the 36 of Chris Johnson. 20 cars there, Cameron Patrick looking for another win this year in the KeysVacation.com modifieds. He's in fourth. Four wins for Cameron Patrick. Two for Mike Rudy, and Sean Beluso gets one at the hands of Mike Rudy, who had that disqualification in the first race for the carburetor, and Rudy, the 8 car, working his way up through the field. Challenge for the fourth position, Cameron Patrick, Joe Scarborough, the 08. He makes the pass. Joe Scarborough now up in the fourth position. Cameron Patrick back to fifth in car 20, being challenged by Daryl Vance in the 87. And here goes Mike Rudy on the outside of the 71 of Hunter Slayton. Dives in front of him. One car slow. Looks like it is the 11. That is Chris Humblett. Back on the racetrack, Mike Rudy trying to work his way back up to the front and get a win. You know he's got to be a little angry about that first win being taken from him. He gets on the inside of Cameron Patrick now, challenging for a top five. He gets it. Top two cars, Sean Beluso and Robbie Babb. Robbie Babb, like we said, he's got a very fast car. He was lightning fast in that first Twin 30. Chris Johnson in third in car 36. Then here comes Mike Rudy underneath. Makes the pass on Joe Scarborough. And right behind these guys, nose to tail, a little bumping and banging going on too. Jimmy Humblett behind the 71 and the 87. Darrell Vance, Hunter Slayton, then Jimmy Humblett. That's 7, 8, and 9. Make that 20 laps to go as we have 10 up in lights. Hunter Slayton, that 71 machine, all over the 87 of Darrell Vance for that seventh position. Jimmy Humblett trying to follow him through too in car 11. Looks like Cameron Patrick's car is going away a bit in the second race. He's driving car number 20, just outside the top five. Here goes the 71 underneath. Hunter Slayton makes the pass on the back straightaway. It's by that 87 of Darrell Vance. Jimmy Humblett is there too. Meanwhile, Robbie Babb is all over the 48 of Sean Peluso for the lead. Almost halfway next to him, almost, but he can't quite get there as we're almost halfway through the race. Peluso giving him plenty of room. Sean Peluso stays on the outside in car number 48. Robbie Babb, once again, the white number 44, diving down low, right up next to Peluso for the lead. Right behind these guys, some good racing. It is the 8 of Mike Rudy to the inside of Chris Johnson. He makes the pass. He is up to third position. Mike Rudy is coming. Robbie Babb makes the pass, takes over the lead on Peluso. He's sideways out of four. Peluso looking to take advantage of the slip. Looks on the outside of Robbie Babb. 15 laps completed. Now that Mike Rudy has gotten by that 36 of Chris Johnson, he has pulled about 10 to 12 car lengths away from him and headed to the front where Peluso tries to chase down Robbie Babb. Peluso's having a hard time keeping his car on the bottom of the racetrack in between the middle of the turns. This is allowing Robbie Babb to escape. Robbie Babb looking for his first victory in 2011 in the modified division from KeysVacations.com. Old Point National Bank night tonight at Langley Speedway, our 4th of July celebration. Fireworks in the sky and on the racetrack tonight, especially at the start of this race, the second Twin 30, when we had that big wreck on the back straightaway, which involved Randy Monroe Jr. Also, it involved the one of Anthony Kincaid and the 77 of Joe Bruce. There he is, the 77 machine. Goes in between turns 1 and 2. He's currently 11th in this race, just ahead of Kincaid. Anthony Kincaid up there, just outside the top 10. Peluso coming back a little bit to the back end of the 44. Robbie Babb for the lead. They make their way between turns 1 and 2. Mike Rudy doing all he can and hoping for a caution flag to get right up to the 48 of Peluso and the 44 of Robbie Babb. Jimmy Humblett and the 71 of Hunter Slate with a good battle for the 6th position. 22 laps into the race. And again, coming up on some slower traffic, Anthony Kincaid just ahead in the windshield of the 44 Robbie Babb. His car gets a little loose at the exit of the turn. And Peluso trying to take advantage of that. Sean Peluso knows he still has a chance. And Robbie Babb again sideways. Car kicks sideways at the exit of the turn. This allows Peluso to gain ground. And he's staying right with Robbie Babb. 5 laps to go, next time by. Peluso again drives the inside. Peluso going at it with just a few laps to go.
Paluzzo makes the pass. He's back in the lead. Bobby Babb, he's not giving up, though. This is exactly what Mike Rudy wanted to see, but I don't think he's got enough time to get up there and challenge. Some great racing going on back a little bit further back. There is Joe Scarborough and the 11 of Jimmy Humblett. They race for the sixth position. Meanwhile, it's three laps to go. Sean Paluzzo wants to win one legitimately, and he is in a good position to do it. He's about 7 to 8 car lengths now ahead of Robbie in the 44. And here is Jimmy Humblett again battling with the 0-8 of Joe Scarborough as they fight for that sixth position. One lap to go for Sean Paluzzo. If he wins the second race, which looks like that's what's going to happen, it's going to be the second win of the nighttime. The first one kind of a give me after Mike Rudy got disqualified. But Paluzzo's going to win this one fair and square as he sees the checkered flag for the KeysVacation.com modifies. Paluzzo wins. And the entire field takes the checkered flag. 71 and the 11 go by, and that was Hunter Slayton hold off in a big challenge with Jimmy Humblett. Hunter Slayton holds off Jimmy Humblett for that fifth position, but Sean Paluzzo gets one the way he likes to win them. Fair and square and up front. Robbie Babb with a great run tonight. He's second. Mike Rudy finishes third after coming from the rear of the field. Chris Johnson in the 36 car fourth. Hunter Slayton fifth. Jimmy Humblett, the 11, is sixth. Joe Scarborough, the 0-8, seventh. Cameron Patrick, eighth. Darrell Vance, ninth. Anthony Kincaid, 10th. Joe Bruce, the 77, comes back after that big wreck and finishes 11th. Brandon Harding, the 32, 12th. And you had Chris Humblett, Todd Van Gilder, Matt Carter, and Randy Monroe Jr. with that big crash on the first lap. He finishes 16th. We want to thank you so much for making us a part of your weekend here at Langley Speedway. We'll see you back next Saturday night for the Hampton Heat 200. $10,000 to the winner of the race. And here's Chuck making his way over to Sean Paluzzo.
And, of course, watching Bruce, the official track photographer, take that winning shot. Sean Paluzzo puts it in victory lane, picks up a pair of twins here tonight. Two wins for the 48, which were absent in 2011, but he's still leading the points. This is what he needed to get that momentum going again for this team. And he wanted a win bad, and tonight he picks up two. So the 48 puts it back in the checkered boards and becomes victorious here at Langley Speedway. Old Point National Bank on track, and they're going to be presenting Sean with his second trophy of the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Sean Paluzzo. And the celebration water hits the air. And the preacher. Well, first off, man, it's been a while since I've been able to talk to you. As a matter of fact, I don't think I've been able to talk to you all year. You finally put it in here. Two wins, a pair of twins tonight. Points leader, defending champion. That takes a little pressure off of you, doesn't it?
No. No pressure. The guys have worked their tails off this year. We've never had to work this hard to beat this great group of guys that we race with every week. I knew the only way I was going to beat Robbie tonight was let him go ahead of me and just use up his stuff, and I just kind of rested mine a little bit and then came back when we needed to. And I couldn't have done it without these guys here. Big John, the owner of the car, he is the man. He works very hard on this. Gary, TJ, Tripp, and my backup driver, Todd Van Gelder, all these guys worked their tails off. I got my family here tonight, my daughter Bree, my daughter Bryce, and my wife's working tonight. Yeah, so anyways, thanks the fan. You got to tell people to come out here and see this great show that we have every week. How about that Grand Stock race? I mean, all the races here are great. And we really appreciate everybody's support. Keys, call the people at Keys. I'm talking too much, but you know the deal. Tell your friends to come out to Langley Speedway. Next week's a Hampton Heat. It'll be a great race. Hopefully we'll have the late model out here if we get some sponsorship.
Robbie Babb, giving congratulations and a great run there, man. I tell you what, 44 is another one you got to contend with, and the talent keeps just every week you see someone emerge as someone you got to beat. But you had to win. You won tonight twice.
it's funny. Everybody we thought we'd need to look out for is doing okay, but the guys we never even thought of have been spanking us every week.
That's what you got to do. Let's meet our friends from, of course, Old Point National Bank. We'll get a photograph there, serving our community since 1923, oldpoint.com. And don't forget to check out their Facebook page, like them on there, and you get a chance to win a lot of great prizes.